I'm Rachel, and this is Dash 101. In our first episode, we explained why we need a better monetary system which works without central institutions. Now let's discuss how decentralized money works. The first thing that needs to be clear when we talk about money is who owns it. With physical cash, it's easy. If I hold this banknote in my hand, it's obvious that it's mine. And if I give it to you, it's yours. With digital cash, it's a bit more tricky because you can't touch it. So you need a digital key to prove that you are the owner of a digital coin. And if you want to send it to someone else, you need to digitally sign the transaction with this key. Digital cash works with cryptography, which is a special form of mathematics. It's all about scrambling and unscrambling data. You don't have to become an expert in this field. All you need to understand is the concept of the public and the private key. They always come in pairs. For each public key, there is a unique private key. Both are strange combinations of letters and numbers, but don't worry, you don't need to learn them by heart. There is a special kind of software called a wallet, which will handle the keys for you. The public key, or more precisely, the address that is generated by it, can be compared to the number of a bank account. If you want to send some money to a friend, you need to know his bank account number, or in our case, his public address. Unlike a bank account number, everyone can have an unlimited number of these addresses. But all you can do with this public part of the key pair is send money to it, nothing else. If you want to spend that money, you need the other half of the pair, the private key. This can be compared to the PIN code of your bank account. You need it to access your money. So you really should keep it secret and never share it with anyone else. If you want to send money to someone, you need to sign the transaction with your private key. The key itself never leaves your computer or cell phone. It's needed to digitally sign a transaction, and this signature proves that you are the legitimate owner of the money you are sending. The math behind this is rather complicated, but making a transaction is really simple. You fill in the public address of the receiver in one field, the amount that you want to send in another, and click send. The rest is being handled in the background by your wallet software. Shortly afterwards, your friend will see in his wallet that the money is on its way. And after the transaction has been confirmed by the digital cash network, he can now spend it. We'll explain in our next episode how this confirmation process works.